guys, so in this video let's talk prove this Viète's formula. So we are going to prove that 2 divided by pi will equal to square root of 2 divided by 2 times the square root of 2 plus square root of 2 divided by 2 times the square root of 2 plus square root of 2 plus square root of 2 divided by 2. Okay, I don't want to waste your guys time, but this is a very interesting formula, and you can check out my pi playlist math related to pi. So I will leave the link below. So that there are another two pi approximation. One is called Leibniz series, and one is the so-called Wallis product. Okay, so before I start, I hope you guys subscribe to my channel. Okay, so let's start. So there are other two ways to. There are many ways to approximate pi. So let's make a small table. So one is the so-called Leibniz series. Says that 1 minus 1 over divided by 5, 1 plus 1 divided by 1 minus 1 divided by 3 plus 1 divided by 5 plus 1 divided by 7 will equal to pi over 4. So this is the common one, and then next is the so-called Wallis product. And then the proof can see my channel, so I will leave the link. So this is the infinite product form. Okay, so this is the Wallis product. And then next, in this video, we will prove this more interesting called the Viète's formula. Okay, so let's give the proof. Let's notice that, our goal is to prove that 2 divided by pi can be written as a square root of 2 times this. So I don't want to keep pronouncing the stupid thing, but I keep going. Okay. So let's notice that. So let's start from notice the common trigonometric equality. Maybe you guys should know that sine x is equals to 2 sine x divided by 2 times cosine x divided by 2. Okay, so let's see. So I can keep going, say that sine x equals sine x is equals to I use this formula again on this sine x divided by 2, so it becomes 4 sine x divided by 4 cosine x divided by 4 cosine x divided by 2. Okay, and then we do the same thing here, so we get that sine x equals to 8 sine x divided by 16 sorry divided by 8 okay maybe I shrink the group 8 cosine x divided by 8 cosine x divided by 4 cosine x divided by 2. Okay, and then we keep going. So let's say we do it n times. So we should get sine x equals to 2 to n sine x 2 to n product n from 1 to 2 to the n n from 1 to okay, I from 1 to n okay cosine x divided by 2 to the I, right? Okay, I think up to now everyone is okay. Okay, another thing we need to use is a calculus, right? Everybody knows about calculus, say that sine x divided by x approaches to 0. Approaches to 1 as x approaches to 0. Okay, so once you have this, then let's take x to be, pi over 2, okay? Okay, so what about the left hand side, right? So the left hand side will be sine pi over 2. The right hand side is 2 to the n sine pi over 2 n plus 1 product I from 1 to n cosine pi over 2 to I plus 1. Okay, and then we take n to be infinity. Okay, so when n goes to infinity, then left hand side is always 1. And the right hand side will be infinity, right? But notice that the pi divided by 2n plus 1 will approximate to pi divided by 2n plus 1, right? So this tell you that these two terms cancel, become pi divided by 2 times I from 1 product infinity cosine pi divided by 2 to I plus 1. So which tell you that 2 divided by pi is equals to cosine pi divided by 4, the first term is 4, pi divided by 8, pi divided by 16, pi divided by 32, and keep going, right? So this is actually already the answer. So this is the Viète's formula. Okay, but we can do more. So everybody knows about cosine 45 degrees, square root of 2 divided by 2. And what is cosine pi divided by 8, right? So there is a formula that says that cosine theta divided by 2 is a square root of 1 plus cosine divided by 2, right? If theta is in the 0 and pi over 2. Okay, so this term is a square root of 2 plus 1 half square root of 2. So you can change, make it to 2 plus square root of 2. And you can keep going, so you can see the next term will be 1 plus this. So 1 plus this, take a square root of 2, divide by 2. And then you do the same thing, so you can see that this guy is also half times 2 plus square root of 2 plus square root of 2. Okay, so you just keep going, then everything is clear. Okay, so done. Okay, so this is the third approximation that we will encounter. So maybe the next time we will introduce some interesting equality in the pies, in the pie. There are many strange series which you can approximate pi. But I think this Wallis one and the Viète one and the Leibniz one are three famous. Okay. See you guys in the next video, and hope you guys subscribe to my channel.